Hello everyone, today we will understand a mini restaurant billing software project architecture in MVC C#. I have created one mini sample project in MVC for C# using following tools. Like I have used like jQuery, Bootstrap, CSS, HTML, Entity Framework, MVC 5, and C#. Database I have used SQL Server 2014. So I am running this project. After that, I will explain it. Okay, now it's run successfully. I am explaining this only functionality of this project. It means how it works. All coding part I will explain step by step in upcoming video lecture. Okay, so today I am explain only how this project will work. Okay. So I have created simple project for billing of any restaurant. Okay, like I have created drop down where that is a customer and payment type, final total, item is a one drop down, unit price, quantity, all these things. Okay. So first, if I select any, first of all, I will select any customer. Okay, research and development, cash total. So I implemented, suppose that item customer wants to in order of any item like french fry. Okay, if you select french fry, then its price automatically bind in next text box. I have put it read only, the user cannot change it. Okay. So quantity, how many plate you want french fry? Okay, I want 5. Okay, I want 4. If you put it 4, then one plate of 50 rupees, then 4 plate of 200. Okay. If you want to give discount, you can enter it. If you want 10 rupees discount, then total automatically minus which amount you want to discount. Okay. So total amount is total price is 200, 10 rupees discount is equal to 190. So I am add to list. Okay. If you click add to list, then all total will be displayed like this, total and final total is this. If you want to add one more item, like I want to add fried rice. Okay. Fried rice is the price of 150 plate. So I want only 2 plate. Okay. There is no discount on fried rice. It's like 300 at least. If you add to list, see 190 plus 300. 190 is the first item. And 300 is the second item. So total amount is 490. Okay. 490. Total amount is 490. If you put like proceed checkout, okay. So I have implemented this type of logic. If balance amount is zero, then payment button will be enabled. Otherwise, payment button will be disabled mode. So whenever balance amount is not zero, then you are not able to click on payment. Okay, so payment total is 490. Suppose that customer give you 500, okay? How much 500? So balance amount is minus 10. Balance amount is minus 10. Minus 10, it indicate you have to return 10 rupees to customer. If you return amount, if you return total 10 amount, 10 rupees, okay? If you enter 10, after that balance amount will zero, then payment button is enabled. Suppose that I remove one, okay? When I remove one, then payment button is disabled. If I put it again, no, okay? Balance amount is zero and payment button is enabled. So I click the payment, I have put a breakpoint, so I adjust it, put it continue. After that, we will check the message. Continue. I think one more continue. Okay. One more continue, okay. I have, one more continue, okay. Yeah, your order has been placed successfully. After that, we can check in the database, okay. I already opened my database. First of all, I need to transaction, okay, transaction table. Yeah, this I like a 1955, okay. Transaction date 1955. As of time 1955, 755. Two amount is two. One more item ID. This and this. And if I check the order detail, press F5. Order detail is this 300 and 190. 50, played unit price 50, this, okay, orders, okay, 55 orders detail, order table, this is my order table, okay, order table, final total, whatever you want, final total 490, okay, after giving 10 rupee discount 490. So all data has been successfully inserted in the database, okay?
Right now, and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.